Hello, welcome to another episode of Healthy You. I'm your host, Erica Rivers. Okay, I have been looking forward to having today's guest on for a few months now. She is in great demand, not only because she's multi-talented, but also because of her amazing spirit. She can get you into shape if you join her belly dancing class. If you're giving birth, she can get you through your pregnancy. Oh yeah, and in her spare time, she's a mediator and professional litigator. I am so excited to welcome to the show today, Mayasa Telfair.
Mayasa, hi, how are you? My gosh, I'm so glad to have you here.
Thank you so much for having me. I appreciate it.
Yes,
thank you.
You just landed at National and came right over. We are so happy.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Okay, what were you doing where you just had to come in and fly in so you could do our show?
I was actually helping a group of women support another woman who was pregnant. And so during the preparing her body for pregnancy, you know, we gather in a woman's circle and we do movements and we dance and we celebrate life and help her to have an easy birth and usher the baby into.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, so it was an amazing trip. It was awesome. A lot of positive women dancing and moving and laughing and smiling. And mom-to-be was working out, and she was doing a lot of the movements that you would generally do in childbirth.
Wow.
So this was all preparatory. It was amazing. So that's what I was doing.
Now, is that sort of tie-in also to the belly dancing? The
Absolutely.
Origin? Okay, so we're going to talk about that.
Absolutely.
Because I read that.
Yes.
And so, but I have the expert here to tell me about it. But so we're so happy. And so in honor of your celebrating, we're going to celebrate that you're here, we have some wine.
Oh, nice.
Would you be interested in having this?
Is it vegan?
It's vegan. Well, yes, I believe it is vegan, but not everybody knows that all wines are not vegan. So can you tell our audience about how do you ensure your wines are vegan while I pour us a couple of glasses?
Okay, absolutely. So because I have a desire to drink wine, I have to ensure that it does meet my qualifications for being vegan. So what I generally do is I open up an app that is available to anyone, and I put in the name of the wine, and it will tell me if this wine is vegan or not. And it just gives you a lot of information when they've contacted the company, what they had to say about it, because generally wine is filtered. Through the filtration process is when wine generally loses its component of just being grapes. So the filtration process is done through finning. Finning can be done with gelatin. It can be done with pork skin. Okay.
No, really?
Okay, really. Yes. Right.
Okay.
And it can also be done naturally.
Okay.
So because it's done in different ways, it's important to, you know, check the finning process.
Very, very important.
The filtration is very important when you're dealing with wine.
Yes. We wanted to ensure this was vegan wine, so we went to your app.
Very nice.
And it told us this wine is good to go.
Good.
Okay, so this is a Shiraz. And so here's a glass for you.
Oh, well, thank you, beautiful.
And for me. And
okay.
So cheers.
Okay.
All right, welcome.
Thank you for having me. Let me taste a little bit. I like it.
I like it too.
It's dry.
Okay, yes, it's a very dry. Do you normally like dry?
Dry is good.
Dry is good, okay.
And it's red, and red is supposed to be very good for you,
right? Because there's less sugar in the red if you're trying to watch your sugar, which I am.
Mm-hmm.
So, okay, so so that we're not having wine on an empty stomach in the show gets too exciting.
Mm-hmm.
Let's get some food going. So what are we going to be cooking today?
Well, today we're going to be preparing some raw kale.
Okay.
And we're going to mix it all together, and we're going to marinate it with using just the lemon to break it down, and we'll have raw kale and avocado salad.
All right. So kale is so good for you. The healthy green.
Absolutely.
Lots of, I guess, antioxidants.
Absolutely.
And fiber,
yes.
So we have a kale. So our other ingredients are, so we don't need really exact measurements, we can kind of eyeball it.
Okay.
So I guess for the lemon juice, so what is that about?
This is organic lemon juice, maybe about a half a cup.
Okay, half a cup.
Yes.
And then we have?
Salt, sea salt, and kelp. which is a form of seaweed.
Oh, very
organic.
Nice. And how much is that, would you
maybe
say?
Maybe a tablespoon.
Tablespoon?
Yes.
Okay, and then we have?
Nutritional yeast, okay. A tablespoon of nutritional yeast.
Okay, so why nutritional yeast?
Only because it can change the flavor, and if you are a vegan or vegetarian, a lot of times there could be an iron deficiency. Mm-hmm. This is very high in iron, okay. And it helps to balance it out. It gives it a great taste. Mm-hmm. You can use it on salads, popcorn. So it's an amazing taste. You know, you have to be mindful of it can, you know, mm-hmm. mess with your digestive system if it's very sensitive. So just be mindful.
Okay.
You know?
Yes. All right. Awesome. And then we have?
Cayenne pepper. Gives it a little kick,
okay,
you know.
Definitely.
And definitely gets the blood, you know, boiling and hot and spicing us up.
Okay. And,
you know, we like
and
that. This is fresh garlic.
And how much garlic is that?
Yeah, maybe a tablespoon.
Okay.
Yeah.
All
yes.
right. And?
Organic, unfiltered olive oil.
All right. All right.
Mm-hmm.
Mix it all together.
Absolutely.
All right,
definitely.
Then. And then we have?
Two organic avocados.
Okay.
Yeah.
And we're going to add that in. Okay, you'll
absolutely.
Show us how to do it.
Yes.
All right, then. All right, so what's the first step?
First step is we'll take this lemon juice, right? Mm-hmm. Because the acid in the lemon breaks the kale down.
Okay.
Right?
So
we'll take this. Mm-hmm. And we'll just drizzle it a little over
okay.
here.
Okay.
Right?
So we put our lemon juice over the kale.
Yeah, just so it can.
Okay. So the kale was rinsed and prepped before.
Absolutely.
And some apple cider vinegar mm-hmm. and water. So that's a good way. Always wash
absolutely.
Your veggies
always
before.
Always wash your veggies.
Always wash your
even
veggies.
Even if you can wash them in alkaline water, mm-hmm. it can bring them to life. It's really good. It can revitalize your greens if they're starting to wilt.
Mm-hmm.
So cold, okay. fresh water is
okay.
great.
All right.
Yes.
Awesome. All right. So we have our lemon juice in. What's the next step?
Sea salt.
The salt
also breaks it down.
Okay.
Right?
So okay, this is easy so
this
far.
Is very,
I can do
this is very
yes.
easy. This is a very simple recipe.
While you're cooking, I'm just gonna
keep simple.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, okay.
So have a little sip while
yeah,
you're doing the work.
Is,
okay,
this is amazing.
So then the next step is.
So the next step is I put the nutritional yeast, the cayenne, and the garlic in last.
Okay,
right?
That's last.
Yes.
Okay, then.
So I'm gonna put the oil on.
Okay. Then.
Okay.
So we're gonna keep using this bowl, or you wanna switch to another bowl?
We're gonna keep it here
keep
for
it
a moment,
here
and then
okay.
we'll transfer there before we cut the avocados.
Okay, perfect.
Okay.
All right. So now it's time for our
olive oil.
Our organic olive oil.
Absolutely.
All right. So you just drizzle that on.
Unfiltered, unrefined olive oil is very good. At its most natural state.
Okay. I mean, so far this is like super.
This is easy.
Easy.
I mean, this is like lunch and
yeah,
like 2 second lunch.
I could do
yes.
this.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yes. Okay.
So we need to massage this.
We need
up.
To massage
yes.
it. Okay. So I think I remember you have a thing where you would like to have gloves on.
Yes.
Okay. This let me
yes.
get some gloves for you.
Thank
okay,
you very much.
You're welcome.
And these don't have anything in it because the last thing you want is you know plastic
okay.
or rubber inside of your gloves.
Okay,
right?
So where do you normally get your gloves?
You can get them from a cooking store.
Oh,
any
okay,
cooking
okay,
store.
Cooking, okay.
Yeah, Bed Bath & Beyond, mm-hmm. or any type of store that sells cooking mm-hmm. things, right?
Okay. Then.
And it has nothing in it.
Nothing
it's no
in it, just,
vinyl or, I mean,
okay.
what's the powdered stuff? That,
right. Sometimes they put in the
yeah,
gloves.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah.
That people can be allergic to, too, right?
Oh, okay. I didn't know
yeah,
that.
Yeah, yeah. It's high sensitivity, too.
Okay. All right. Yeah. Excellent. So right? now to break down and mix everything in.
Yes. Okay, we start so. This whole massage.
Okay,
thing,
so
right?
you're just going to massage.
Yes, and don't be afraid, you know.
Get in there,
and, mm-hmm. you know.
Mm-hmm.
Like, really, oh my gosh, see, you can smell it. It smells so good. And it's looking all pretty.
Mm. Oh, wow, that looks amazing.
No, right? Who would have thought?
Okay,
like, it
yeah.
can really break down.
Okay, right? then. Oh, so you're just kind of breaking, you're massaging, you're
just
getting
massaging.
All the oil and the
yes.
lemon juice into
and
it.
And the salt.
And the salt, yes.
yes.
So the
yes.
flavors are just going to be yep. mixing together.
And you can take the stems of mm-hmm. it, you know, mm-hmm. and throw those in your juicer and have some juice with it.
Oh, okay.
So you're not wasting
okay.
the kale leaves,
all
right?
Yeah, so you can use every part.
Every part.
Yes.
No, that's right. All right, so this is pretty much broken all the way down.
Okay.
All right, so we can transfer that into.
So you would have a bigger bowl.
A bigger
here.
Bowl. I'm gonna pull some of these stems off here real quick.
Okay.
And you could just use this and
okay.
put it here. And what the reason I transfer it is because the lemon juice
mm-hmm.
is at the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if you're into, you know, your food juicy. Mm-hmm. Then, by all means, mm-hmm. you know,
yeah,
you can
some
use
people
this.
Like a little bit of dressing,
right,
some people
exactly.
like a heavy dressing.
This is true.
So, it's,
right.
So that just depends. So.
Right, it just depends.
Okay.
I personally am not a big.
Okay, so you just like a medium light
dressing. Yeah, I don't like
dressing.
It, like wet food,
okay.
so,
mm-hmm.
you know, just gloves and.
All right, perfect.
Okay,
okay
right.
so what's the next step?
So, the next step is I'm going to take these gloves off because I don't need them anymore. This
okay.
part is done. Oh, and it looks
awesome.
Pretty, right?
It looks
just
very
changed
beautiful.
From just, yeah.
Okay, so I can get rid of our stems and our cloth. Why
thank
don't you,
you
have a sip? This is yours.
Okay.
Okay, well,
all right,
you know,
thank
in between.
You.
Okay.
All right. Okay. So next step is
cut the avocados.
Cut the avocados. Okay. Yes.
You want to cut one with me?
Well, you know what? I'm going to let you do that because I don't have a section on the cutting board. I'm not really sure.
Well, you can use it right in your hand, but.
Okay. All right. Well, we'll let you do
that.
Let
me cut it.
Okay. Yeah. All right. So we have two organic avocados. Mm-hmm. And avocados are very good for you, but I remember somebody telling me they were high in estrogen.
They are.
Okay.
They are. They're high in estrogen. They're high in good fats.
Uh-huh.
But if you are a woman who has fibroid issues or womb issues, I don't recommend you eating an entire avocado.
What?
Yes, not a day. I recommend
the
eating
entire avocado in my smoothie.
This is all personal, but I only recommend a half an avocado because of the estrogen levels that are associated.
Let me just have a sip to take in
the process. Always,
what you just said. Okay,
yes.
All right.
So take it easy with your avocados.
So maybe a half an avocado every other day, maybe.
Yeah. Or you can have a half each day.
Each day, but just be mindful that there is estrogen.
Absolutely.
Okay.
And when you put your avocado in the refrigerator so that it doesn't turn brown, oxidation from the air, you can leave the seed in it and put that cover
right back on it. Okay.
And it will keep it green and fresh for you. Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, so that's a little tip to keep, so you know
absolutely.
That's a way to keep it from being brown. Leave the seed in and put the covering back over.
Mm-hmm. And stick it in the refrigerator and use it the next day.
So nature's got us, basically.
Absolutely, definitely.
All right,
for sure.
Awesome.
All right.
Oh, you do that very nicely.
Well,
okay. Well, I guess that's why you're the chef. Okay, right. Awesome. Okay. Oh my gosh, it looks so good.
Now we just want to put the remaining of the seasonings on because so we'll do some nutritional yeast here.
I think I can help with this. Okay, and then I'll let you do the garlic.
The garlic. This is a very simple recipe. Very simple if you have picky eaters, picky children.
Okay, so.
You know, it's
just
awesome.
Sprinkle that all on.
Well.
You want to get that?
Yeah, yeah, let's get that out of there. You need a little kick.
All right, so
this is your fire. This is what heats you up. So a lot of times people don't like to eat cold food in the winter. Add cayenne pepper to it.
It's going to give you some more.
It gives you some more.
It's definitely going to give you some
absolutely.
More.
Absolutely. Okay. Yeah, for sure. So you can just kind of like stir it all around in here.
Oh, very nice.
Yeah.
Okay. And this was quick. So people are like, I don't have time.
I know.
Prepare.
You can do this.
I
fix this for breakfast in the morning.
Like, oh, my. It's so quick. Running,
getting
out
the door.
This is definitely faster than pancakes.
Absolutely. For sure. And you know, it's just amazing. Mm-hmm. And you have your smoothie too, with your lunch from the stem.
Yes. Okay. And this is also portable. So if you make this size, you can have half of it for breakfast and
absolutely.
Take the other in a container for lunch.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Yeah. This
awesome.
This is a grab and go meal.
Definitely a grab and go.
Yes.
Okay then. All right. So.
Yeah. Oh, I like
so
it.
We're done.
That's it.
Oh my gosh.
I mean, it's really that simple, and it's going to be so good.
Okay. Oh, my gosh. I can't wait. But so, all right. Now that we've finished our first dish, we're going to pause for a short service announcement. Up next are the wraps.
Yes.
Portobello avocado wraps with mushroom.
Well, the mushroom is the portobello.
Oh, that's the portobello. That's
yes.
right. Okay, sorry. Oh, that was the wine. Okay, so the wraps are coming up. So we'll be right back with Mayasa.
Absolutely.
Stay with us.
Sounds wonderful.
For years, scientists have explored remote corners of the Earth, searching for exotic substances that might help prevent cancer. At last, man has discovered a secret place where powerful remedies can actually be found. Medical research shows that a vegetarian diet, rich in fruits, vegetables, and whole grains, can help prevent many types of cancer. Wherever you live, cancer prevention is as close as your grocery store. To learn more, call 866-906-WELL.
All right, we're back. Thank you for staying with us through the break. Mayasa, I think I need to top you up just a little bit here.
All right.
Before we get into our wraps.
Well, thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, I'm going to have a sip. Okay, so portobello wraps. What do you like about this one?
I like this because it adds texture. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm all about texture and food. And portobello gives us the texture. And if you are transitioning from vegan from vegetarian or from meat eater to mm-hmm. vegan or vegetarian, or you just want to try something healthy.
Okay.
Portobello gives you a texture very similar to the texture of meat. So I actually like working with portobello, and it's very good for you as well.
Okay, so what all are going into our wraps?
Okay, so we're gonna do some portobello.
Okay.
Alfalfa sprouts.
Okay.
Some lettuce, onions, and avocados. And you could add hummus to your wrap as well.
Or if you don't like the mushrooms or you're allergic to them.
This is true. You can add just a vegetable wrap. So onions, peppers, lettuce, tomatoes.
Sun-dried tomatoes.
Yeah, absolutely. I love sun-dried tomatoes. You can put an array of vegetables in it, you know, green beans and just whatever you like. You can make a kale wrap. You know, you can take some of that kale
right.
and put it in there with these ingredients.
Or lettuce wraps.
Absolutely.
Okay, so here's the thing. Now with our wraps, as you know, I'm gluten-free.
Yes.
So we have two types of wraps here. Mm-hmm. So the flour wraps
yes.
and the gluten-free wraps.
Absolutely.
And so I'm going to have the gluten-free, please,
okay.
if that's okay?
Absolutely.
All right, then. So we have our skillet here.
But I do want to tell you really quickly, though, okay. sometimes with the gluten-free wraps, because of the contents that they use to produce them, mm-hmm. they can break and fall apart.
Oh, okay.
So what you would do instead of folding and using your wrap to fold, mm-hmm. you may just place one on the top mm-hmm. and one on the bottom. Bottom, mm-hmm. and make it almost like a pie,
okay.
very similar. Put mm-hmm. your ingredients in, put it on top, mm-hmm. and then cut it, mm-hmm. you know, uh-huh. and then eat it that way
okay.
versus the whole rolling wrapping. And wrapping process
okay,
just
then,
because
right
of
then.
The ingredients.
All right, so I'll work mine out. You
okay.
Know. All right,
yeah,
then. Okay,
definitely.
So let's go. Okay, so the portobello mushroom. So what
yes.
do we need to do? We have our skillet here,
yes.
and it's warming up. It's
it
pretty
is.
Warm.
And I love coconut oil for
okay.
portobellos
all right,
because
so coconut
oil is a really good fat. So we're going to just put in maybe a couple of teaspoons of coconut oil.
Okay.
Organic coconut oil.
Organic
yes.
coconut oil.
Coconut oil is amazing for the body.
Okay. Well, why is coconut oil so good?
It's a great fat. Inside,
it's a great
outside,
fat.
It's historically known for hair, skin, body. Mm-hmm. Inside, lubricant. I mean, it's just great.
Okay.
You know?
Then so I can use it on my hair. I can use it on my face as
absolutely.
Well as my inside.
Absolutely.
Okay,
definitely.
Then. All right. So that's melting quite nicely.
Yes.
And I see we have some seasonings in here.
I did.
And
add
so,
a little, just a little. Mm-hmm. Just because we're going to marinate the onions.
Mm-hmm.
And so we want to add a little seasoning to the onions as we marinate them. And okay. they go in first.
Okay. And so what seasonings do we have in here?
Just salt, pepper, and a little garlic and that's about it, just for the onions.
Okay,
and we're gonna add some other things to it. So.
All right then.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, salt, cayenne, and that's it.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. So let's start with some onions.
All right. Right. Sounds good.
All right. Let's just put these in here.
So all
and
in.
This is just like a half an onion.
Half an onion.
And so you don't have to put this entire piece into your wrap.
Okay.
Right?
All right.
It's
so
just
it's kind
two,
of
two
flavor.
It's flavored, and you know you put some in there and mm-hmm. kind of stir that around.
Mm-hmm. Do you want to stir this?
Yeah. Just stir it around real quickly.
Okay. All right.
Yeah, and just you can let those kind of do their thing.
Okay, so I'm cooking. I'm cooking.
Yes, you are.
It's easy.
Absolutely.
Everybody can do this.
This
if I
true.
Can do this, everyone can do it.
And you can marinate your mushrooms in some sesame oil or coconut oil.
Oh,
put your seasoning on them.
Okay.
And you don't even have to warm them because it starts to break down very similar to the kale.
Mm-hmm.
You can just marinate them and cover them, put them in the refrigerator. The next day, they're very, you know, broken down. Or 15 minutes. It doesn't take long, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely.
Okay.
So we can start with taking these and placing them into the pan. We're
okay.
going to use lettuce,
mm-hmm.
Garlic, basil. I love basil mushrooms. And turmeric.
Okay.
Turmeric is amazing.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's a healthy.
It's an anti-inflammatory.
Absolutely.
Okay.
So if someone has any seizures or any type of swelling or turmeric is amazing.
Mm-hmm.
Garlic, of course, is centuries of health and healing. The basil grows right out of the garden, and it's amazing.
Mm-hmm.
So these
so
are
many
all,
great uses.
It is,
yes.
It is definitely. Alfalfa sprouts are good.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they give us those iron and stuff, make our skin real healthy and things
okay.
like that.
All right, well, bring
yeah.
on the alfalfa.
All right, sounds good. So do you want to place these in here and allow them to just, you know, start to marinate, put
okay,
the mushrooms
then.
In? And,
all right, let's all do
right.
that.
Let's just, we can just slide them on
okay.
in there, all right?
That's okay.
Real
all right.
simple, right?
Perfect.
Just no
perfect.
Long process and,
all right, so just Let them marinate.
Yeah, just letting them marinate. Mm-hmm. Because it's coconut oil, we don't want to necessarily cook it in a high heat.
Okay.
I have to be very careful with our high heat and low heat temperatures when we're dealing with oils.
Okay.
Particularly olive oil, coconut oil. Mm-hmm. You know, we don't want to, because actually it can turn rancid and carcinogenic.
Okay,
right?
We don't want that.
We definitely don't want that. So, you know, when you're dealing with olive oil, turning the heat up, like frying in olive oil is a no-no.
Oh, we don't fry in olive oil.
We don't fry in olive oil. If
olive
you
oil.
Look at different studies or FDA, they will actually tell you as well, it turns carcinogenic, which is cancerous.
Okay, so it's heated. Something with a high heat point.
Absolutely.
Coconut oil.
Yes.
Is great for that.
Absolutely.
Okay, so that's why. Okay, got you.
So we want to be careful when we're frying and sauteing with these heat temperatures.
Oh, perfect. Perfect.
We don't want to be eating all healthy and taking
exactly.
These.
Yes, exactly. So
this is basil. Just fresh basil.
So we're
going to
put our basil on top, sprinkle that over.
Yes.
All right, awesome. This smells really good.
Does it? Some garlic.
We have our garlic.
Yes. It's only like a teaspoon of garlic. Just a little garlic.
Okay, then. Yeah. And get the rest of that.
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
Yeah. And turmeric.
Mm-hmm. Yes. And just sprinkle that.
Yes.
So are we flipping now or?
Not quite yet.
Not quite yet.
You can also add curry to it as well.
Okay.
Right? Like curry.
If you had a curry sort of powder already
Absolutely.
Mixed.
Definitely curry powder can be
that
a great
amazing.
Addition to add to your mushrooms as well. Mm-hmm. All right. So we can kind of let that marinate and kind of do its thing.
Okay. Yeah.
My grandmother used to always say, you never watch a boiling pot.
Oh, okay, all right, because I'm like right focused on it. So, but while we're waiting for this to marinate, can you tell us a little bit more about your business? You are very much into the divine feminine, and one of the ways that you accomplish that is by a series of these amazing, fun workshops, which I can say they're fun because I've been to them not once, but twice. So tell me more about your workshops, how you support the divine feminine, and your business.
Okay, so I love women, right? Because I don't have any sisters.
Oh.
Yeah, I love working with women. I think it's amazing. I don't know how we can survive without having a sister.
Mm-hmm.
So sisterhood is very important to me, you know, grabbing a woman and gathering her up and, you know, helping each other to support each other through life because we need each other essentially, right? We're connected.
Yeah, like you were doing yesterday.
Absolutely.
With the woman who is about to give birth.
Absolutely. So it's an exchange, right? Mm-hmm. I'm giving and receiving, and you're giving and receiving. So there's an exchange that takes place. And through this exchange, we become better women. You know, we become holistic, you know, and just happier and free and just, you know, releasing a lot of things that have kind of kept us in these positions of stagnation. So I love working with women. And one of the things I do to support women is I offer weekly belly dancing classes.
Okay.
Yes, I do on Sundays. Mm-hmm. It's just, you know, come and it's a community day of women from all nationalities, from everywhere. And we dance and we celebrate the joys of being a woman. And so I love belly dancing.
Okay.
I've been belly dancing for a long time.
Okay.
And, you know, gave my children belly dancing. So that's just something that I love to do. It's something that supports women, done for women and by women.
Okay, now and your business.
Yes.
And what do you do in your business?
So my business deals with vaginal steaming.
Okay.
Right?
All right. And I heard Gwyneth Paltrow was into that.
Really?
Yeah.
This is interesting because this is an old ancient technique.
That's
right?
How, because, but she kind of made it like interesting and popular or whatever there, and that was this whole thing. And I read about that. Tell me more about that.
So vaginal steaming deals with womb health.
Mm-hmm.
And because we deal with a lot of different issues as women in our womb, a lot of times revitalizing our womb is important.
Mm-hmm.
And we use herbs to do that. So there's a big pot that sits underneath of you. You're sitting up because you are a beautiful queen on a throne. There are herbs placed under the pot and they go up into your womb. You are completely covered, right? Nothing is exposed except your head. And you sit under the steam and it goes up into your womb. And if you're dealing with a womb issue, these herbs are particularly beneficial for you because they adhere to whatever issue you may be having. But if say you don't have an issue, say you have a perfectly well womb, then they're really beneficial too for you as well, somewhat like a manicure, pedicure.
No,
it's something that we have to get done.
This is very interesting because I, like, I'm into all sorts of cultures. So mm. I go to the Korean spa.
Yes.
And I've seen something like this
absolutely.
At the Korean spa.
Absolutely.
So this is sort of an ancient technique,
very ancient.
But you've just put a modern twist on it. So we're not kind of just outside in nature.
This is true.
I can just come to your place.
Yes, absolutely.
And have everything set up.
Definitely.
Okay, then.
Definitely.
Oh, so that sounds amazing. Now, if I wanted to read more about that, what website could I find you?
It's timeforhealing.com.
It's time for healing.com.
Absolutely.
Okay. So tell me, you have a workshop coming up, don't
I do,
you? Okay.
I do.
It's on the 23rd?
Yes, I do.
Of this month.
Absolutely.
Okay. So tell us about this workshop.
So this workshop is, again, mm-hmm. dealing with women and women's health and mm-hmm. their sacral mm-hmm. part of who they are as women, which is their yoni mm-hmm. health. And I teach women how to use yoni egg gemstones, right?
Okay.
Yoni egg gemstones are ancient practice as well. Mm-hmm. And what it does is it tones, mm-hmm. tightens, empower, mm-hmm. uplift, mm-hmm. and allow women to be multi-orgasmic.
Okay.
Yes.
All right. And
yes.
who doesn't want to be multi-orgasmic?
Right. Who,
I mean, just
who,
like, really?
Who yes. would not
okay,
want that, right?
All right. So with if regular practice and dedication to
yes.
it, you can have all sorts of benefits.
Absolutely. You're always smiling.
Always smiling.
Right? No okay. one knows why you smile, but you're always smiling.
You're always smiling.
Yes.
Okay.
You're
you have this happiness.
You have this happiness. Is like,
what
glow.
Is people are like,
absolutely.
Wow, what is with her? Okay.
Yes.
So you've
and
been working
use,
on your yoni health.
Absolutely. And we use gemstones. And the gemstones come from the earth.
Mm-hmm.
And so they're connected to the earth. So they have metaphysical properties associated with them.
Mm-hmm.
And you use them for vaginal weightlifting,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
To lift the muscles, the pelvic
mm-hmm.
floor muscles,
mm-hmm.
tone, tighten, lift.
Mm-hmm.
Helps with incontinence.
Mm-hmm.
You know, women who, you know, laugh, sneeze, and cough may have urination
mm-hmm.
or birth after having birth to help to revitalize the womb. Or if you're preparing for birth, it helps to get the womb
mm-hmm.
and prepared, or if you are just in the mood for upliftment, empowerment,
mm-hmm.
and a healthy womb, mm-hmm. this is what you do.
Okay, you know, it seems like the mushrooms are ready, so what are you doing here now?
I'm just cutting them just so that they are palatable within side of the wrap, that they're not too large.
Okay.
So I'm just slicing them and going to get ready to prepare the wraps.
Okay, so this is what they should look like when they're just about done.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, then so they've turned like a really nice dark kind of brown color.
Yes.
And I can see that the garlic and the oils and the onions have all marinated in.
Yes.
Okay, then. All right, so when we come back, we are going to plate the wraps and Mayasa is going to show us how she rolls them.
Absolutely.
Okay, then so stay with us. We're going to have one more break and then it's time for plating. Okay, so we are back, and this is my favorite part of the show, the eating.
Mm-hmm.
But before we get there, we have to make the wraps. I can't eat just yet. Okay, so Mayasa, show us how to make the wraps.
Okay, so traditionally, we can just warm the wraps up.
Okay.
And you can warm them really quickly, you know,
mm-hmm.
throw them in a pan with
mm-hmm.
a little oil, flip, 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 throw
mm-hmm.
them on a burner, you
mm-hmm.
know, whatever your
okay.
heating preference is.
Okay.
And you place them on a plate.
Okay.
Let's start with a little lettuce here.
Okay, then, so yes. we have lettuce.
Yes.
Okay, so.
You want to use that too?
Okay,
grab the lettuce.
Wanna,
yeah.
Just one piece of lettuce
mm-hmm.
right in the center?
You can put it
on the side.
On the side.
Okay,
as well.
Then. All right.
Or put all your ingredients down the middle,
oh,
right? So slide
okay.
it over to the middle.
Okay,
you can do
then.
That.
All right, then, there we are.
Alfalfa sprouts.
So we'll take a little bit of alfalfa.
Yes.
Maybe a little bit more.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Let's get some avocados in there. And then you can start getting the,
okay.
and so you don't want it to be dry, you can actually make avocado mash,
mm-hmm.
you know, by using tomatoes and avocado to give it, or a little hummus. Hummus would have been good too.
Okay, right? Oh yeah, hummus is a nice filler if you
Absolutely.
Are allergic to mushrooms.
Yes,
then
yes.
you could use hummus as a substitute.
Mm-hmm. Right, so we just put just a couple of pieces of avocado
A couple
in
of
there.
Pieces of avocado.
Right, that's pretty good there.
Oh, perfect.
Right, and we can fold here. You put some onions on there.
Okay. Oh, yes. I forgot the onions. There we
are. And if it's too dry, you can always drizzle a little of that.
The oil
the
on oil there.
I'll try
to get
there.
Yeah.
yeah.
Okay.
So it's not like
All
right.
right?
So
perfect.
You can take this here.
Okay.
And you can fold the side. So
mm-hmm.
you fold one side.
Mm-hmm.
You fold the other side, right?
Mm-hmm.
Two sides. Then you can take it
mm-hmm.
and
get it in there
really good, right?
Okay, kind of like they do at Chipotle.
Don't.
But no, not don't. That.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
But
yeah.
But vegan.
Yes.
Okay, all right.
And there's your wrap, right?
All right,
so
yeah.
You can actually put this in your pan
okay.
to warm up your tortilla oh. as well, too, to warm up the outside.
Okay, then.
Right? So you don't. You can either warm it up prior
okay.
or you can warm it up after. So let's try one of the gluten-free.
Okay, so we have done a wrap with a flour tortilla. And so now, could we do one with a gluten-free one? Because I'm gluten-free,
absolutely.
And I want to taste these amazing mushrooms, but I can't eat that. What's that? Oh. Okay, yes, and Jorge's gluten-free, as he very importantly said. So I want to see what we can do with the gluten-free wrap. So
absolutely.
We have a nice, fresh plate, because we don't want to do cross-contamination. Mm-hmm. So if you're making a flour wrap for yourself, be sure to use a new plate, new utensils, because gluten is a very serious problem for people, and we don't want anyone to have an allergic reaction. So,
absolutely.
Okay, so now, because they're gluten-free, we kind of know sometimes the flours that they use don't always behave mm-hmm. nicely like the traditional wraps.
Right.
So what can we do with the gluten-free one?
We can just make it work. We can do, so you can do two on top of each other like this, right?
Okay.
Put all your vegetables in,
okay.
and then you could just make, you could cut squares or triangles with it, and then,
okay.
or you could just do one, and okay. I'm sure it will work just fine. It would just be almost like an open air sandwich type,
okay.
right? So let's try that. So let's
maybe
do some
a little
lettuce.
Bit of lettuce.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, there. And you know what I'm going to do is I'm going to put it on one side and then just fold it over, maybe, so it doesn't, because I think.
Yeah, let's do that. Let's yeah. just one roll.
Yeah, and then.
Maybe another piece of lettuce, maybe?
Another
no,
piece of.
Only, yeah, well, yeah, just a little small piece.
A small one, I
only
think.
Because we don't want the, sometimes the mushrooms can kind of soak through.
Okay.
And, you know.
So there.
Yeah.
And then we can add the mushrooms.
Absolutely.
And then some onion.
Mm-hmm. And your alfalfa sprouts.
Okay.
And here's an avocado.
I'll just reach over you, pardon
mm-hmm.
me. And there, oh my gosh, that looks so good.
It looks great,
mm-hmm.
right? And we can begin.
So maybe just fold it over?
Absolutely, almost
okay.
like a taco,
okay,
right?
Then. All right then, so we're going to plate. So can you just kind of put that on this plate
absolutely.
Here?
How about that, like that?
Yum!
Yes.
Okay then, and then so.
I can put some
salad.
Kale
yes.
salad up there, right?
No, don't forget the salad.
Mm. Absolutely
okay.
wonderful.
There we go,
okay.
perfect.
And.
Okay, so we'll put some, we'll move the burrito here. To this plate and then some salad.
Absolutely.
Right
oh,
there.
Wow.
Yeah.
That looks nice. Uh oh.
So
gotta get that
yeah, yeah.
good fat avocado on there.
It doesn't want to leave.
All right.
All right. Perfect.
All right, okay.
Okay, then. So now is the moment that I have been waiting for.
Oh
my favorite
gosh.
Part of the whole show. So we have there.
Wow, this is nice. This looks so amazing.
It looks so good. Look at that. How great.
Very
does that
simple.
Look?
If you have some.
Simple. We have our wine.
Yes.
There.
Absolutely
yes.
amazing.
And my wine here. Hmm. So, how quick and easy was that?
Very quick. Very right, easy.
Then. All right. Okay. So, one more cheers. Cheers to
yes.
our wraps.
Absolutely.
Our mushroom portobello wraps and the kale salad.
Absolutely. Right. Thank you.
Okay, so now we taste. First, I'm going to start with the salad.
Let's see what it's working with here.
Okay, see how it turned out. Mmm.
How is it?
Oh my gosh.
Wait, you gotta wait for me. You can't be enjoying all this goodness
mm-hmm.
without me.
Yeah,
right?
I am. This is so good. The lemon juice.
Mm-hmm.
You were right. It worked all the way through.
Yeah, definitely.
Mmm. So good.
That was
okay.
good.
That was very good.
Wow.
Okay, so now.
The wrap.
See my wrap.
Yeah.
I have my gluten-free wrap here.
And I have me
gluten-free.
A good wheat, vegan.
She has the wheat one. Vegan.
Wrap.
If you are not allergic to gluten, then that can be the wrap for you.
Yeah,
so.
Let's try this out.
I'm going to have mine like a burrito, so
yeah,
cheers.
Cheers.
Mmm.
Mmm. This is good. Mm. Mm-hmm.
It's really fresh and crisp.
Mm-hmm.
And the alfalfa sprouts and the portobellos
mm-hmm.
are amazing.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my gosh. Mayasa, thank you so much for showing us how to make this quick, easy meal
and for all your tips and information.
Absolutely. This is for the working moms, you know?
All right. May I come to your workshop on the 23rd?
I would love to have you.
Okay, then.
I would love to have you. We're sipping tea, too.
Oh, it's tea. I love tea.
I make teas. This is going to be amazing.
Come. Oh, my gosh.
Yes.
Okay, all right. I am so there.
Yes.
23rd. So if they see this after the 23rd, you have these workshops pretty periodically.
I do. Absolutely.
Okay, so they can just go to the website.
Yes.
See definitely. When the next one is coming up.
Yes.
A little birdie told me you do retreats in Jamaica.
I do. I love to go to Jamaica. God. I love to go to the Caribbean.
And people can sign up.
Absolutely.
And go to your retreat.
Yes.
In Jamaica.
Yes.
And
yoga. We do yoga. We do belly dancing. We do hot, fresh springs. We do beach walks. And oh my gosh, it's amazing.
Gosh. Okay. All
it's
right.
It's amazing.
So I don't care when that is. Sign me up. I'm coming
you
to
coming?
That too. But let's start slow.
Okay.
Okay. I'm at the workshop. Okay.
Right. Yes.
Thank you so much for joining us today. Thank our beautiful guest, Mayasa, for taking time out of her very busy schedule to be with us. Be sure to find our Healthy You TV Show page on Facebook or go to our website at healthyyoutvshow.com. And remember, a plant-based diet is a fantastic foundation for a happy, healthier you. See you next time. Okay,
all right.
Let's keep eating.
Sounds good. Thank you so much for having me. I really appreciate it.
Oh my God, thank you for being here.
Yeah, this
oh my
is
gosh,
awesome.
It was so much fun.